American Jewry just can't seem to come to terms with one of their own, namely former Jewish Secretary of State under Nixon, Henry Kissinger. The outrage all began when Jewry lashed out against Kissinger for foisting a paper defeat upon Israel in the Egyptian Sinai, while the Israelis, under the command of General Ariel Sharon, were on their way to Cairo during the last days of the Yom Kippur War in 1973. The Camp David Accords that followed in 1978 gave the Sinai back to Egypt, and Sadat continued his drift away from the Soviet Union. Soon, Egypt completely left the Nasser-initiated Soviet sphere of influence in the Middle East. It was Kissinger, although out of power during the Carter administration, who laid the framework of the Camp David Accords. For Kissinger, seeing an opportunity by giving Sadat a manufactured victory in the Sinai, was acting all along on behalf of his fellow Jews by bringing Sadat over to America and sending the Soviets back to the USSR. You see, Kissinger, contrary to his detractors' opinions, was not really Nelson Rockefeller's New World Order man. Kissinger was essentially a Jewish power player, and that meant helping Jewry's global position however and wherever he could. Thus, it can be said, Kissinger was essentially a Judaic World Order man. Seeing this Jewish bent in Henry Kissinger, Nixon ordered his aides to exclude all Jewish Americans from policymaking on Israel, including Kissinger. According to notes taken by H.R. Haldeman, Nixon is quoted as saying, "Get Kay out of the play. Let Haig handle it." But Jewry, to this day, continues to accuse Kissinger of being on the Arab side, although all the while Kissinger was swaying the Arabs away from Russia and into America's, that is, Kissinger's own Jewish lap. And Jewry let loose its most intense outrage when in declassified tapes in which Nixon is heard saying, "Jews are aggressive, abrasive, and obnoxious." Kissinger told Nixon that if the Jews were thrown into gas chambers in the Soviet Union, it was not an American concern. "Maybe a humanitarian concern," added Kissinger, "but not an American one." You see, an American concern for Kissinger is whatever plays into his own gamesmanship. The man can easily speak out of both sides of his mouth. On the one side of his mouth, he supported Clinton sending U.S. troops into Bosnia during the genocide of Serbian Christians by Bosnian Muslims. But on the other side of his mouth, he was against sending U.S. troops.
"I do not want to oppose the president's deployment of troops. If you had asked me 2 years ago, I would have said we must not send troops into Bosnia. There's no national interest involved."
And all the while, Kissinger was calling for a Muslim state in Bosnia and for the ethnic cleansing of Christian Serbs in Bosnia by packing them off to Serbia.
"We are now at a point where we've dramatically changed our policy towards Bosnia. How do you assess where we are and where we ought to go?"
"I believe that what we should do is create a Muslim state, permit the other nationalities either to make themselves independent or join Croatia and Serbia, as the case may be."
Again, on the one side of his lips, Kissinger, during a hardball MSNBC interview, said that a Clinton intervention, this time in the 1999 Kosovo crisis, was not in America's interest. Yet, on the other side of his lips, Kissinger said at the outset of Jewish Secretary of State Madeleine Albright's bombing atrocities against Serbian Orthodox Christian civilians, "Now that we're in there, we must do all that is necessary to win." What is it, dear Henry? Is it simply a matter of any amoral gamesmanship in which you must always come out on top? Perhaps this is why McGeorge Bundy, Kissinger's original mentor at Harvard and career launcher, said of him after seeing enough of his protege's countless schemes, "Kissinger doesn't lie because it's in his interests. He lies because it's in his nature." In January of this year, Kissinger paid a visit to Jewry's most feared leader, Vladimir Putin, hoping to pump some inside information out of him. But after Putin, who is now protecting Syrian Christians against Jewish imperialism, gave Kissinger no more than 40 minutes of his time, Henry told reporters, "Putin is a patriot and a nationalist," hinting that a new Cold War was coming our way. Well, whether it's Cold Wars or Hot Wars, humanitarian concerns or American concerns. Kissinger, like his fellow tribesmen, the axiom, is it good for the Jews, seems to strike at the very nature of all things American.